Hey everyone, this is Kirisu, and tonight I'm going to be working on some art. So those of you who have been here the last few nights, I've been working on sort of a fan canon project, where the artwork is just based on sort of random lore that we have had everyone make in chat over the course of like just the time that I've been streaming. So I'll go ahead and switch over to that screen. So on screen we have Kirisu and my dog, who everyone in chat has, given the code name Huey. That's not his actual name, but I don't usually like to share pets' names just because of privacy reasons. But yeah, this is codename Huey riding on a bear. A magical pair? Question mark. The world may never know. But last night we finished line art, so I'm going to be starting on some color. What if Huey was like those dog buddies from Monster Hunter? Oh, you mean like the, what was it? I forget what they're called. Because I know the cats are palicos. I don't remember what the dogs are. Palamutes? Yeah, that sounds right. Yeah, and that would kind of be appropriate because Malamutes and Huskies are kind of similar. Like, they're a bit different. Like, Malamutes are usually a bit bigger and poofier. But, yeah. Yeah, I think Palamutes is right. I haven't really played a bunch of Monster Hunter, aka I haven't. But I have watched others play. You haven't finished your Monster Hunter Rise game yet? Yeah, I'm not sure about that game. Like, I haven't seen anybody play that or anything, so I don't really have an opinion on it. You saw there are two people now. Let's see. Yeah, it looks like we have five people now. So for everyone joining, welcome to my channel. My name is Kirisu. I am a digital illustrator and hobbyist gamer. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit. Tonight I'm working on some Kirisu fan canon art. Art that is based on just sort of lore that everyone has made in chat that is an actual Kirisu canon, but it's fun to draw anyway, just because it's fun and nonsensical. Let's less monsters in Monster Hunter Rise. That actually surprises me a little bit. I would think that there would be more. But yeah, tonight I will be starting on Color. So a little bit about how I color my illustrations. Generally, I have each main detail of a part of the drawing on its own layer. And I usually will color all of this in like sort of a medium to dark gray until I actually go through and add the final colors. Just because that way I don't have to worry about like trying to color match when I don't have the other colors in the palette to compare to. So, like, doing it this way is just a lot faster because I can focus on getting the sections filled in and then worry about what will look better later on when I'm changing all the colors. Because I can just preserve the transparency so I don't have to worry about, like, staying in the lines or anything. Actually, the only reason why there's less is because Monster Hunter Rise was meant for Nintendo Switch and the console is small game fit. Yeah, that makes sense. You're really surprised at how big the map is for Final Fantasy VII. Yeah, like the Final Fantasy games in general are kind of surprising in that aspect. Because, like, I've never played them personally, but just like based on what little I know about them, like, there's a lot of content. Oh no, that was the wrong layer. That's okay though. It was just a little bit, so we don't have too much to redo. You thought it was gonna be a short game? Yeah, I mean, like, that's fair with it being as old of a game as it is. Like, I wouldn't have expected it to be, like, super long, but I mean, like I said, Final Fantasy does kind of push the boundaries as far as what video games are capable of. Because, like, especially with like the newer games, like the graphics and the style of art that everything is a lot better, in my opinion, than a lot of games. It's gonna be better than you thought. You started playing at 14 but got bored. Is that one of the ones that's online, or is that single player? Because, like I mentioned, I am not super familiar with the Final Fantasy games. I just really like the art style. Like, that's all that I can really say about them. Okay, yeah, that's what I thought. So, what's everyone up to tonight? That line is not supposed to be there like that. Go ahead and fix that. Just laying down and watching the stream? Awesome. So if anybody is interested, I am always down for Q&A. If anybody has any questions about my art process, me in general, or if you want to like comment on things that you would like to see in the community, I am always open for any of that. Because like, just a little bit of background, my biggest goal with streaming is to sort of create a community where everybody can be sort of safe and welcome. Because I think that that's really important, because there's not a lot of spaces like that online where everybody can just be themselves. And I mean, obviously there are some limitations to that. Like, I don't accept any type of like harassment or like bigotry in any capacity on my channel, but as far as like people just like expressing themselves and sort of getting to interact with everybody, I think it's kind of cool the way everything works out here. Risu and Huey is Monster Hunter character fan canon. Oh my gosh. Hey, welcome to chat, Lone Wolf. Oh my gosh. I mean, I could imagine that, but at the same time, I've never really played Monster Hunter, so I don't really know if that would fit. I mean, maybe. Yeah, everything went well. Yeah, if you want to send a map, you can, Sniper. Yeah, you're good. I'm not really sure yet what Huey's color scheme is going to be like. Welcome back, Sniper. What makes it Final Fantasy Unlimited? That sounds interesting. Hey, welcome to chat, Julius. How's it going? An older anime series. For some reason, the map is see-through, so you could basically see Cloud standing in the ocean. Interesting. Kiwi says hi, by the way. Oh my gosh. That's always exciting. Oh, he says hi again. They said hi to you. Gosh, Sniper. He would love that. Hey, welcome to chat, Foxtrot. How's it going? Yeah, I agree. The beef flavor instant ramen is probably one of the best. And then chicken after that, which is surprising because usually chicken is my favorite. That makes sense. Huh. That actually sounds like it might be good. I might try it eventually. I mean, like actual like roast beef and not ramen that's flavored like roast beef. It looks like Lone Wolf used my hydrate redeem. Tonight I am just drinking water. All right, and that portion of our stream was staying hydrated with Kurisu. Yay, hydration. Portion stream hydration Kurisu. Oh my gosh. You ridiculous foxtrot. You made a water potion. No, portion. Lots of potions contain water, you are correct. Full sniper? That's crazy that it took that long to get it to the first city. Unless you just mean that you like went back to it, but I don't know. I wasn't sure because I've never played. So I was like, maybe it's one of those games where you start like out in the middle of nowhere. Played the new Zelda game yet? Oh, sorry, Second City. Oh my gosh. Sounds like a really big adventure. Kind of curious, is the new Zelda game available on PC, or are they still sticking to just the Nintendo consoles? So I would probably consider playing on like a PC port if there was one. I kind of want to consider seeing if I can find Majora's Mask for PC. Might have to use an emulator. Oh, just on Switch? Yeah, I figured. What game is that, Evie? Welcome to chat, by the way. That's really funny, Sniper. What does everyone want to talk about tonight? For pretty much anything. For anybody who is currently joining us tonight, I am working on a Kirisu fan canon piece based on lore that was created by our viewers in chat. So this particular artwork is based on my dog, which chat has lovingly given him the code name Huey. That's not his actual name, but it's kind of just an alias, I guess, because I don't usually share pet names for privacy reasons. We're kind of just here with him floating on a pear next to me. It's a good time. What if Huey was from space and you found a pod when he or she were a pup? Yeah, Huey is a boy. So he uses he him pronouns. And if I found him in a pod, I would probably still take him home with me, honestly. Like, I wouldn't have said no to a puppy, because puppies are great. You're a good sniper. Yeah, I've never played Kingdom Hearts either. Like, it seems like an interesting universe, but I just have never played. Because I think, if I remember right, when it came out, it was on GameCube, wasn't it? I never had a GameCube. So, what does everyone want to talk about tonight? So amused by Curious's expression in this one. Because, like, usually I draw Curious with more of like a neutral expression, I guess. Just because, like, generally speaking, I usually have a pretty neutral expression on my face. But it's kind of amusing seeing her just completely unamused. If a dragon came out of nowhere in a cut, oh, a dragon did come out of nowhere in a cutscene. Oh no. and you didn't have a chance to attack either? That's crazy. Like, was that the way that cutscene was supposed to go? Because I know sometimes there are cutscenes where you're just, like, along for the ride, and then others you actually need to play the game. At least you didn't have to restart. Yeah, that's always a good thing. Sniper, I'm glad you like it so far. I don't usually do that. Probably the only piece that I have where Kurisu's hair isn't black is one that I did. Hold on, let me save this. One that I did a while back. It was another sort of chat's choice type piece. Where we had Kurisu as a Super Saiyan Blue. Gonna just open that. Zoom in a little bit so we can see easier. But yeah, aside from that, I don't really think I have any other art with Kurisu in a different hair color. Thanks, I'm glad you like it. You're a good lone wolf. There's no need to apologize. Yeah, I'm working on coloring right now. No, not ads. What if he was a frog in disguise to scare away animals that want to eat him? Oh my gosh. I mean, you never know. Right. Oh my gosh, I'm putting Huey in a frog suit. That would be hilarious. I am skeptical, lone wolf. Huey is as well. Oh my gosh, rave frogs. Lone wolf is trying to start our raid back up. Yeah, I understand that. Can't do the rave frogs yet. Let's see. That one doesn't tell me what kind of emote it is. Give me one moment. I'm gonna see. Oh yeah, that would explain it. Yeah, there are some emotes that unfortunately you have to be a sub for. Like, I would love if everyone could just use all the emotes. That would make life easy and fun. My gosh, Sniper's here with all the frogs and he put cheese at the end of it. You're ridiculous. Oh my gosh, Sniper. Oh my gosh, thanks for the gifted sub, Lone Wolf. Looks like we have gifted one tier one sub to Overtired. Awesome. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Oh my gosh, thank you for the second sub, Lone Wolf. Lone Wolf gifted a sub to Kuro. All the emotes. Oh my gosh, sniper. What kind of soup is your brain? So curious now if you're trying to remember the ingredients. That's good that it didn't take away any of your points. Yeah, I'm not sure why the emote-only chat hasn't been working properly, but it's never worked on my channel for some reason. I'm not sure if it works on anybody else's or not, though. It's kind of just one of those, like, default ones that Twitch offers, so I think maybe their coding got messed up or something. I've never had the spicy shrimp ramen. Like, I've never had any of the shrimp flavor ramen. So, like, I don't know if I would like it or not. Because, like, I'm not really a huge fan of shellfish. Because, like, when I have had shrimp in the past, it was breaded. And I think that was more something I liked just because of the breading and not the actual part in the middle. Hey, welcome to Chat Hunter. How's it going? Your brain is ramen and your blood is green tea. Oh my gosh, sniper. That sounds like a bit of an emergency. Wow. And your heart is made of rice balls and your spine and bones are sushi. That does not sound stable at all. Yeah, I have. Maybe not like a weird opinion on spicy food, but like, I enjoy a lot of foods that are spicy, but I only eat them because of the flavor and not because they're spicy. Because, like, if I like the flavor of something, then it doesn't matter if it's spicy or not. But then, like, I will never understand people who seek out foods just because they are spicy. Because, like, I don't know. I'm not really into that. Seafood in general. Oh my gosh. Like, I'm okay with seafood, just not really a fan of shellfish. So, like, I'll eat, like, fish. Like, salmon is usually good. It's like a less fishy fish, I guess. but I don't really have like a whole lot of experience with trying like a bunch of like really specific things. Because aside from that, I've mostly just had like fish sticks, and I don't think those really count as seafood, even though they are technically a derivative of fish. Yeah, I guess it depends on what kind of seafood you're eating, though, but it can definitely get messy for sure. Yeah, I mean, like, they are technically fish. It's just like, wait. Like, I'm pretty sure they're made from fish, even though they have the different texture, because it's kind of like, I don't know exactly what they do to process them, but yeah, I haven't eaten fish sticks for a while. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. 'Cause like I figured, but I didn't want to like speak on it without knowing. 'Cause like they kind of remind me of fish flavored chicken nuggets a little bit. 'Cause chicken nuggets are basically the same thing except chicken. What are you talking about, Julius? I mean, where's the lie? Fish sticks are totally just fish flavored chicken nuggets. Just made from fish. Yui says hi again. Have fun, Julius, and be safe. Oh my gosh. let's see. Kirisu and Huey in space on a walk. Oh my gosh, sniper. Let's see. What am I doing tomorrow? Currently I don't have any plans, so it's up in the air. Oh my gosh, Julius. It's still important to try to be safe at least. Which part, sniper? I was saying, let's see. I read your message about Kirisu and Huey in space on a walk. Then Kuro asked what I'm doing tomorrow, and I said I don't have any plans yet. So you didn't really miss much. Hey, welcome back, Lone Wolf. Oh my gosh. Kirisu is like that moon goddess from Japanese folklore. Which one? Oh, girl. Not familiar. Might have to look into it. Oh my gosh, strawberry cheesecake ice cream. Sounds really good. Hey, welcome back, Julius. All right, I made the mistake of hitting a button while my program was saving, so just give me one moment. I'm gonna reopen this. Yeah, it's really random because sometimes it decides to show the progress bar for the saving on my other monitor. So I thought it was done, but that's okay. Let's see what progress we lost. Okay, just the air, that's not bad. Oh no, sniper. Sounds like something that might be a spoiler, so make sure you don't share that, all right? You're awesome. Thank you. That's hard to say. Because, like, I don't know. I think my, like, the proportions of my characters, I think, are pretty close to, pretty close to what they have in Final Fantasy. I think I just draw my eyes and faces a little bit different, mostly. So I would guess, if anything, like, that's probably the biggest change that you'd see if I put them in that style. Let's see, any good meals today? I made ramen tonight. So that was pretty good. Like, I'm actually really surprised because it is surprisingly easy to make from scratch. Like, there's only a few ingredients that really go into it, depending on like which variety you're making. Because like the ramen that I make has like a miso soup as the main like soup part of it, and then I just kind of boil some ramen, add some like seasonings and stuff to that, and that's pretty much all that goes into it. Dumb question. What would Kurisu look like with a Venom symbiote? That is a good question. I mean, because Kurisu's color palette, aside from her fur, is pretty dark anyway. So, color palette probably wouldn't change much. I'm guessing the spots that are orange would probably be black instead. But I'd have to probably think about that one. Maybe eventually. I'm not sure. I know that there is a little bit of a lag between what happens on screen and what happens in the stream. I don't know if it's that long, because I know there is a bit of a delay between when messages are sent and when it pops up on the screen. I don't think there's that much of a lag, as far as what we have going on. Give me one moment. Yeah, so it looks like there's about an 8 second lag between when I do something on screen and when it actually happens. That said, if there is more of a lag than that, it could just be your internet connection. So a few ways to troubleshoot that. If you want to try refreshing, sometimes that fixes it. But aside from that, my only recommendation would maybe be like resetting the router, but it could just be the internet speed that you have in general, so it kind of just depends. Okay. Yeah, you're good. I hope everything works out for you. Welcome back, Sniper. I'm glad to hear it worked for you. Definitely an improvement. Huey got some spinach from a sandwich I was eating earlier, but nothing too exciting for him today. He's saying hi again. Well, maybe it's not being as loud as I thought then. The fluffiest tails are the best tails. I agree, Sniper. Double doggos sounds like a good time. Yeah, I'm glad you're enjoying it, Sniper. It sounds like it's a really interesting game. One moment, let me pull it up here real quick. Tonight, this is the playlist that we have. No, I can't do copyrighted music, unfortunately. Welcome back, Sniper. I don't really have a favorite soda, but I guess if I had to choose, I would probably say grape soda of some variety. I've never really been a huge fan of cream soda, but I don't know, it can be okay. I'd say along those lines, I probably prefer root beer as an option, just 'cause usually they are side by side when that type of option is offered. I don't know. I don't usually drink root beer, but it's pretty good in root beer floats. Dr. Pepper is kind of hit or miss. It's not bad, but I need to be in the mood to drink Dr. Pepper to want Dr. Pepper, if that makes sense. Because it's a really acquired flavor. But yeah, the lemon lime sodas are all right. That I think is pretty much. Oh, great. I was on the wrong layer. One moment, just gonna redo this real quick. It's basically the drink that they replaced Sierra Mist with. I'm pretty sure it's probably the same thing or close to it. Pepsi Nitro. What's that? Creamy uncarbonated Pepsi. Everything about that sounds awful. Oh my gosh. All right, I'll see you later, Lone Wolf. Have a good night. No, I just haven't added color yet to the pear. 'Cause usually when I am coloring, I put down I guess like a base layer that's just gray. And then I go back through later and actually put the right colors in. It's just a lot faster during my coloring process so that I don't have to like try to color match while also like putting all the colors in. If I had my own brand of soda, what would it be called and what flavor? Let's see. What would it be? It would probably be like a variety of fruit flavored sodas. So like grape and orange and all of those. And then what would the brand be called? Carisu Cola. Oh my gosh. I mean, that works, I guess. Fox Tonic purple flavored. Oh my gosh. Yeah, definitely the grape would be purple flavored. Oh my gosh. Blue raspberry would be Mana Plus. Fox Tonic Cherry Bomb. So, I would not have a cherry flavored soda in my line of drinks because personally, I don't like cherry. But that's just me. Yay, Kuro is starting our rave back up with our rave frogs. All right. Yeah, I love the frogs. They're like one of my favorite emotes, I think. On that note, I am going to be right back. Just give me a couple moments, please. Thank you. All right, I'm back. Sorry about that, everyone. So finished with flat color, debating on if I want to start shading tonight. Thanks, Sniper. So yeah. There we go. I was trying to get my avatar to work. Oh, Huey says hi again. So yeah, I'm kind of debating if I want to start on shading because that takes a little while, or if we want to save that for the next stream. They say hi to you. He's kind of just like, oh, whatever. Oh my gosh. You're all fantastic. Oh, he says hi again. Trying to get him to be a little quieter this time of night because we have neighbors, but he does not want to listen right now. Yay, frogs! So many frogs. Spam all the frogs. One moment. Just gonna paste a few frogs in here. Yeah, he did actually. I'm surprised that nobody heard that. Oh my gosh. All the frogs. So yeah, I'm thinking I'm probably gonna be finished with working on art for tonight. So I will leave it up to all of you if we want to do Q&A for a little bit or if we want to raid another channel. He sounded like an Xbox notification. Oh my gosh. Yeah, I mean, I'm not super tired at the moment. I'm just kind of leaving it up to all of you. Because, like I said, I'm finished working on art, I think, for now. But. Oh, there's Huey again. If we want to do Q&A, that's cool. If you want to hang out on another channel, that is totally cool as well. So, yeah, I'll give everyone kind of a few minutes to decide on that. Any new movies? No, I don't really watch movies very often. Huey is being so talkative tonight. He wants to say hi to everybody. have you seen any new movies, Sniper? Kuro just used my hydrate redeem. Tonight I am drinking water. All right, and that portion of our stream was staying hydrated with Kurisu. Yay, hydration. He gets kind of talkative when I'm streaming. I think he kind of just likes to be the center of attention sometimes. Oh no. Yeah, I've wanted to see that one. Definitely. Yeah, huskies love to be the center of attention, which is crazy with him because, like, Huey is actually, like, really shy for a husky. But he's, like, kind of opening up a little bit. Like, as far as, like, when we go on walks and stuff. Like, he used to be really skittish, but he has kind of calmed down a little bit. You've mostly been watching Godzilla movies? That's cool. There are 6 or 7 different versions of the Spider-Verse movie out currently. Huh, that's interesting. Like, you mean like different versions is in different dubs of the movie for different regions, or like different variations of the movie? Because now I'm kind of curious. Huh, that's interesting. I would say saying it was a cliffhanger isn't a spoiler, but if you say, like, why it was a cliffhanger, I would consider that a spoiler. So, like, generally, as long as you're not giving, like, actual plot points of a movie, like, oh, this thing happened, or that thing happened, or this character said this thing, then usually I don't really consider it a spoiler. Yeah, you're a good sniper. Oh my gosh, girl. The stream is a trap. No, it's not. Like, I try to be really upfront about my rules as far as spoilers. Because, like, the biggest ones are, like, if a movie or game just came out, like, I think it's, like, super disrespectful to share any details about it at all. But, like, if it's something that has been out for, like, years, like, I'm a little bit more lenient on that, because, like, people have had adequate time to see it. But it kind of just depends. I'm not sure if I've seen the trailer or not. Like, I've seen, like, bits and pieces just, like, scrolling through places, but I don't think I've actually sat and watched the trailer. Might go to see the new Turtles movie. There's a new Turtles movie? That's crazy. It's like they're like, is it okay? So, is it a new like a new start for the story, or is it like a continuation of any of the ones that they've released over like the past while? I probably won't go see it then. I'm not a huge fan of Seth Rogen. It's its own story. Okay. You're being so noisy. You want to say hi? Say hi? No? Okay. Did you know the voice actor for Sasuke does Peter Parker for the what? New Spider-Man game. Hey, welcome to chat, Dark. How's it going? Tonight we were working on some flat color, but I'm kind of finished with that, so we are doing some Q&A for a little bit before we raid out to another channel. Just because I didn't want to get too involved in shading because I will stay up all night working on that otherwise. Huey on a pair, yeah. So on that note, give me one moment here. We'll give a shout out to Dark. Okay, so for anybody who is not familiar with Dark or Dark Ecliptic Heart, he is another artist here on Twitch. If you all want to give him a follow, that would be awesome. He usually streams later at night than I do, so it kind of just depends on when everybody's up, but he often draws and throw art as well. Yeah, there's a pair. Like, so basically, there's that meme where people change the lyrics for, I think it's, I don't know what the actual song title is, but like the lyrics are something about living on a prayer, but they have Huey on a pair instead. Yeah, you're welcome. I try to help out when I can. Yeah, I agree, Sniper. I'm glad that I met you as well. It's always neat to sort of see how people end up in my channel. Huey says hi. He's being noisy again tonight. Yay, Ray Frogs. Yeah, I agree completely. Because, like, let's see. I was a random encounter on Facebook. Yeah, that's usually how things end up. Because I met Dark on Facebook as well. Because I just remember, like, seeing his art in a lot of the different groups I was on. And then I think at one point he may have added me because I don't usually send friend requests. But like I had interacted on one of his posts or something, so it was kind of just random. Yeah. I meet most people on Facebook. Yay, more rave frogs. Yeah, sure, sniper. Oh yeah, I don't have any of the I don't have anything coded in my chat, so like it doesn't really like I don't have any I think they're bots that like tell any information about anything. Everything on my stream is kind of just manual as of currently. No. Yeah, I understand. I hope you're feeling better soon, and I hope you have a good night. I'll talk to you later, Dark. Yeah, I'm not sure if I'm able to check that or not, Sniper. Let me click on your name and see if it gives me any info. It says following since May 14th, 2022. The new kitten is settled in nicely. That's good, Julius. But yeah, I think I'm probably gonna head off as well. Do any of you have any channels that you want me to raid? Like, do you have any preferences? If not, I will probably just pick someone at random. We can narrow it down to either another art channel or a game channel. Over a year already. Yeah. Mythic duo, right? Give me one moment. We'll just copy that. Slash raid. We have our raid ready to go. I appreciate all of you for being here tonight. Thank you so much for hanging out. I will be back same time Friday evening, so that'll be 8 p.m. Eastern time, 5 p.m. Pacific for anyone who wants to stop by. I will be continuing on this artwork unless I start on a commission project between now and then. But yeah, thank you all so much and have a great night.